हेलो गाइस, माई सेल्फ एम डी तारिक अनवर। आई एम वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एट सेंट एंड्रयूज इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड मैनेजमेंट, गुरुग्राम। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर अ लेक्चर ऑफ वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन द सब्जेक्ट फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स एंड द टॉपिक ऑफ टुडेज लेक्चर इज फ्लो थ्रू पाइप्स। I have already discussed different types of topics such as fluid kinematics, fluid dynamics, Bernoulli's equation, venturi meter, orifice meter and etc. So what do you mean by flow through pipes? When the fluid flows through pipes, there will be some loss due to frictional resistance inside the pipe wall, or you can say there is a head loss due to friction when the fluid is flowing from point 1 to point 2. Consider that is the fluid is flowing from the pipe, so it is not necessary that the inside of the pipe or inside wall of the pipe will be smooth. So when the fluid is flowing, there will be some loss. These losses are broadly classified as, first one is major loss and second one is minor loss. So read this definition here, that is when fluid flows through pipe, it encounters various losses, and these losses are, first one is already told, major losses, head loss due to friction, and second one is minor losses such as sudden expansion losses, sudden contraction losses, bend losses, losses at entry, losses at exit and etc. So first of all, I'll discuss here major losses, or you can say major loss because it is only one. So major loss, head loss due to friction, that is the inside the pipe wall. So when the fluid is flowing from one point to another, there will be some loss which is occurring during the flow. It is calculated with the help of formula already explained in the last video lecture series, that is Darcy-Weisbach equation. It is given as HL is equal to FL V square upon 2GD or 4F dash L V square upon 2GD. Already explained, F is nothing but friction factor, or Moody's friction factor, Moody constant. So Darcy-Weisbach equation is used for both laminar and turbulent flow, but the case is the fluid should be steady and pipe should be a constant diameter. Clear? सो हेड लॉस कहाँ भी यूज़ करेंगे, पाइप का डायमीटर सेम हो एंड फ्लो शुड बी स्टेडी. सो लैमिनार एंड टर्बुलेंट फॉर बोथ द केसेस दिस इक्वेशन विल बी यूज्ड. सो यू ऑल नो दैट डिस्चार्ज इज नथिंग बट ए इंटू वी और एरिया इंटू वेलोसिटी. It implies that, or we can write Q is equal to pi by 4 D square in place of A into V. So the value of V will be, after arranging the term, that is 4Q upon pi D square. So putting this value of V in this equation, that is head loss due to friction, that is HL is equal to FL V square upon 2GD. So see the right side after arrow.
एच एल इज इक्वल टू एफ एल अपॉन टू जी डी इन टू इन प्लेस ऑफ वी आई एम पुटिंग वैल्यू ऑफ वी दैट इज फोर क्यू अपॉन पाई डी स्क्वायर का होल स्क्वायर बिकॉज वी इज विद ए स्क्वायर. सो आफ्टर सॉल्विंग वी विल गेट एच एल इज इक्वल टू 16 एफ एल क्यू स्क्वायर अपॉन टू जी पाई स्क्वायर इन टू डी रेस टू 5. क्लियर. सो एच एल इज इक्वल टू आफ्टर अरेंजिंग द टर्म टेकिंग डिजिटल वैल्यू विच कैन बी कन्वर्टेड इन टू डिजिट. सो अरेंजिंग द टर्म एफ एल क्यू स्क्वायर अपॉन टू जी पाई स्क्वायर अपॉन 16 ब्रैकेट क्लोज इन टू डी रेस टू 5. क्लियर. सो आफ्टर सॉल्विंग द वैल्यू comes as 12 means that 12 d raised to 5 in denominator. So you know that HL is equal to, we can write FLV square upon 2GD is equal to FLQ square upon 12 d raised to 5. So these equations, or you can say this equation, in first equation V term is coming and in the second HL value Q term is coming. So if V is given in the question, we will use FLV square upon 2GD, and if Q is given, then we will use FLQ square upon 12 D raised to 5. Clear. Now another question or another formula for this, that is head loss due to friction, to find out head loss due to friction, that is known as Chezy's formula. It is given as V is equal to C under root M I. I'll explain each and every term in the next page. See here. Here I am showing different terms and meaning of each and every term in this equation, that is Chezy's formula. V representing velocity, C is Chezy's constant, M is hydraulic mean depth, and I is the hydraulic slope. It will be more clear when we will take an example. For example, fully flow pipe or fully developed flow, you can say, in the pipe, completely filled with fluid, this is known as fully flow pipe. So in this case, the value of M will be given as the by the formula area of flow upon weighted perimeter. Clear. M is hydraulic mean depth. Kaise nikalenge? This is the formula, area of flow. Area of flow kitna hai? Because the flow is through pipe, the area will be diameter of the pipe, that is pi by 4 d square multiplying by diameter upon weighted perimeter. Weighted perimeter, perimeter of the pipe, that is 2 pi r, or you can say pi d. After solving, we will get value as d by 4. Now we will solve I. I means slope. It is denoted by tan theta. Head loss upon L. See this diagram. I already explained hydraulic slope. So see this diagram here. Hydraulic slope means from point 1 to point 2, when we are moving or covering some distance, there will be head loss. This will be HL in terms of height. Head loss due to friction. When we are going from point 1 to point 2, there I am covering or you are covering some distance. Assume that this distance is L. So applying tan formula means how much theta is, tan theta is P by B. So for this case, P is HL and B is capital L. So tan theta become HL upon L. Again, V is equal to C into under root MI. So putting the value in this equation, that is M and I, the the value of m is d by 4 into I value is hl upon l. So squaring both side, so that we can remove a square root, so we will get v square is equal to c square d into h l upon 4 l. So hl value by this formula we will get as 4 l v square upon c square into d. Clear? Also we know that hl is equal to fl v square upon 2 gd. Clear? This is equation 2. So equating equation 1 and equation 2, we will get the value as after cancelling common term, we need to explain further. So we will get f upon 2g is equal to 4 upon c square. So value of c square is equal to 8g upon f. So c value will be 8g under root 8g upon f. This is the value of c. Clear? So by using this value and putting this value in the equation, you can also find head loss due to friction using Chase's formula and using Darcy-Weisbach equation. Now, clear? Now we will discuss one part of minor losses. Another part we will cover in the next lecture because it comprises different types of losses. So here I am discussing minor losses. The first part of minor losses is losses due to sudden expansion. For example, consider that pipe is changing its area. For example, initially pipe diameter is 20 mm. After some time or after some length, for example 100 meter, pipe is changing to 40 meter, 40 mm. The diameter is changing 20 to 40. This is known as sudden expansion. Fluid is flowing inside the pipe, but there is a expansion in the pipeline or expansion of the diameter of the pipe. So for this case, see the diagram here. The velocity at section 1 means a smaller diameter side, area is A1, velocity is V1, and after expansion or larger diameter side of the pipe is, I have chosen section 2. This is area is A2, velocity is V2. Clear? See another diagram which is right of the, on the right side of the page. Here, due to change in the area, there will be a force is changing. So see that P1A1 is the force acting in the rightward direction, and this is for a smaller diameter area of the pipe. If we will shift this, there will be a minus. For example, here also pressure P1 is exerted, that is P1P1, but area is A2 minus A1, because consider this is the, for example, assume piston cylinder arrangement. So if we remove or reduce the diameter of a smaller pipe, remaining area will be A2 minus A1. So force will be P1 A2 minus A1. This force is exerted in right side direction. So there is a another force which is acting in leftward direction, that is P2 into A2. So you all know that continuity equation is nothing but Q is equal to A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2, or you can say discharge. So you can write V2 value as Q by A2. Another question coming in this case, applying Bernoulli's equation. First we will use continuity equation to finding out velocity V2, and applying Bernoulli's equation, applying momentum equation. There is a correction, I told earlier Bernoulli's equation known. अप्लाई मोमेंटम इक्वेशन विच आई हैव हैड कवर्ड इन लास्ट एंड लास्ट लेक्चर
दैट इज फोर्स ऑन पाइप बेंड्स.
सो अप्लाइंग मोमेंटम इक्वेशन दैट इज पी वन ए वन राइट साइड पॉजिटिव प्लस पी वन ए टू माइनस ए वन इन द ब्रैकेट पॉजिटिव माइनस पी टू ए टू नेगेटिव इज इक्वल टू फोर्स रो क्यू वी टू माइनस वी वन ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन इन द लास्ट लेक्चर. सो सी दिस आफ्टर सिंप्लीफाइंग एंड कैंसिलिंग कॉमन टर्म वी विल गेट पी वन ए टू माइनस पी टू ए टू इज इक्वल टू रो क्यू वी टू माइनस वी वन. सो ए टू इज कॉमन टेकिंग ए टू एज outside the bracket, so we will get P1 minus P2 into A2 is equal to rho Q V2 minus V1. So arranging the term again, the rho ko left side le jayenge, we will get P1 minus P2 upon rho Q upon A2 in the bracket V2 minus V1. Q upon A2 is nothing but already solved with the help of continuity equation, that is V2. So I have shown here with dashed line as P1 minus P2 upon rho is equal to V2 in the bracket V2 minus V1. Now apply Bernoulli's equation here for point 1 and for point 2. So you know that P1 by W plus V1 square upon 2G is equal to P2 by W plus V2 square upon 2G plus HL. This HL is representing sudden expansion loss. So arranging the term again, that is P1 minus P2 upon W is plus P1 square minus V2 square upon 2G is equal to H. HL को right side में रख दिया मैंने और other terms को left side में arrange किया. Clear? So putting the value of P1 minus P2 upon rho, see this already told, P1 minus P2 upon rho value is V2 in the bracket V2 minus V1. So putting this G as it is, because G is present already, so here we will get P1 minus P2 upon rho G. P1 minus P2 ka value rho, so V2 minus V2 minus V1 into V2 upon G. Clear? Rho hat jayega because rho is coming from the last equation. Plus V1 square minus V2 square upon 2G is equal to HL. So after opening the bracket, we will get as 2V2 square minus 2V1 V2 plus V1 square minus V2 square upon 2G is equal to HL. After solving, we will get final answer as HL, sudden loss, yeah, expansion loss due to expansion loss. Clear? Head loss due to expansion, that is nothing but V1 minus V2 ka whole square upon 2G. Clear? So again we can arrange the term in terms of area. Chunki HL, head loss due to expansion, is V1 minus V2 square ka whole square upon 2G. So I am taking out V1 square upon 2G as a common factor. So inside the bracket we will get as 1 minus V2 upon V1 ka whole square. Also you know that A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. Clear? So V2 upon V1 is nothing but A1 upon A2. So putting the value of V2 upon V1, that is A1 upon A2, in this equation, that is head loss due to friction, that is expansion, not friction. So head loss due to expansion, the formula will be V1 square upon 2G in the bracket, that is bracket start, 1 minus A1 upon A2, putting the value of V2 upon V1 as A1 upon A2 ka whole square. I'll discuss different minor losses in next video lecture series. So thank you guys